All right. I think technology's working. I think the stream is working. Hi everyone. Can you see me? Can you hear me? Is this thing on, as they say? welcome to my first ever live stream that I've hosted and not had someone else queuing me up for. Oh my gosh. I'm so excited. I'm so excited to have you all here today. I have admittedly, I never saw myself doing this sort of thing, and yet here I am. And things don't appear to be broken, except for possibly slightly broken, as it looks like Sean is not actually a mod. Let me see if I can't fix that real quickly. Hi, Sean. I don't know why it's not working, Sean. Give me a second. Yeah, that's a bit of an odd one. Oh, technical difficulties. Okay. There we go. Problem solved. Thanks for being patient, guys. I really appreciate it. Okay. Wow. Holy moly. Hi, everyone. Oh my gosh, there is people here. Real live human people. I'm so excited. Oh wow. You can tell I've never done this before because I'm kind of like, wow, I'm trying to figure out how you balance talking about things and reading the chat and doing a thing, which is something I'm actually hoping to do today. But you're here, I'm here, and if you haven't figured out by all the tweeting and talking about it, we're totally here for a very specific reason today, and that is my picture frame, my ultimate picture frame, which many of you will have seen presented at VRF. But for those of you who haven't, and I do apologize for the potential recap, but this is a fully 3D printable picture frame that can accommodate virtually anything. From a minimum, of course, unless you are smart and know how to alter the CAD files that I will be selling with it. But it can take everything from a minimum up to whatever you can imagine. It's pretty magical that way. It can take inches, it can take centimeters, A sizes, B sizes. It's incredibly versatile. And I'm super, super excited to be showing you guys because I've been working on this since July. So it's definitely about time. And I am gonna do my best to try and keep caught up with the chat. Because yeah, there's actually people in here and you guys are saying things and I gotta keep up with that. So y'all will have seen, if you saw my VRF presentation, you will have seen this lovely frame, which is the first one that I actually have built myself. This is actually an A5 frame, and I can't actually take credit for the art either. This is not my art. This one is, though. So this is an A5 size frame, and this is a 14 by 17 inches frame. So already two different frames, completely different units of measurement, and they both work. This one's got a piece of perspex in it, which is something that you can do. I have tried to make this be able to accommodate every potential framing problem that you can come up with. So hopefully y'all aren't gonna poke a bunch of holes in it. And actually, if you can, feel free to, because I want to be challenged today. I want y'all to ask good, hard questions. I want you to make me work for this. I want to explain how this works, how it's awesome, why you need it, and you guys are going to help me with that today. In addition to answering your questions, I'm also going to build one. I've got all the pieces here to build a B4, again, a totally different unit of measurement here, for this really, really lovely piece of work that a wonderful artist named Robin Hobbs made. And I have been waiting to frame this for at least a million years. I've had it for way, way too long, which actually is part of the things don't like to stand up for me. The fact that I have all these different size things is the reason why I came up with this idea in the first place. I'm an international person, if you can't tell by the fact that I sound like an American and I live in the UK. I am used to a bit of international things in my life, and that is not limited to art. I found myself in a situation where I had art in inches, I had art in B sizes, A sizes, and very, very quickly I saw how expensive it was going to get to frame all these things. Now, A size frames are very easy to get in the United Kingdom, so that wasn't really such a big deal, but B sizes and inches are less common. So I found myself staring down the barrel of a very expensive picture frame that I would have to get custom made to accommodate the drawing I made on American-sized paper. So that was kind of where the idea for this came from, was, like many practical prints, necessity, and perhaps a bit of laziness and cheapness to make something a little less expensive. So that's kind of where this came from, and it kind of just continued to grow a bit from there. And before I knew it, I found myself with four different sizing options for the frame. Inches, centimeters, A sizes and B sizes. And just them being able to basically do all the things that I wanted them to do. They've been tested by some wonderful beta testers, and it's very nearly ready to enter into the world. Now, I know that I presented this over a month ago at Birth, and you guys are probably wondering why it's not out yet. I have actually been working with an external programmer, because I don't program, to create a tool that will make planning your frame much easier, because it's not necessarily clear what pieces you may need to create a frame of a given size. So I wanted to help create something that would make the process much easier. So I'm working with a really cool person right now who is building me a little web tool that will come with the frame and will make planning your frames as simple as typing in the measurements and getting a readout of what pieces you need to print. So I'm really, really excited about that. And it's very nearly done. I am very nearly done with the instruction guide, which is incredibly extensive, and we'll go through how to test your printer to figure out what sizes you need for this to make sure that you get a good fit, how to print, how to assemble, troubleshooting, the whole nine yards. I am putting a ton of work into it. So I really hope that you guys are excited for this. It will, unless touching wood, knocking on wood, barring catastrophe, it should be up very soon and well before Christmas. But have I touched the wood enough? Have we circumvented any jinxing? I think we're good now. Yes. So no. So the frame is not in beta per se. I had employed the help of some beta testers who printed the frames on their printers and tested the fit for me, because the pieces fitting well together is actually incredibly important. And as all of us know, I'm assuming that everyone here is a 3D printing person to some degree, and if you're not, then this might not make as much sense. Have your tolerance, the tolerances on your printer are obviously not going to be the same as the next person. Everyone's got a slightly different printing tolerances on their printer. So it fitting well is important. And that means that I have gone out of my way to make sure to be releasing files that will work with everyone's printer. This is definitely part of the reason why I have been exporting STLs until my eyes bled. There's going to be a huge, huge range of files to choose from to make sure that you are printing pieces that will work for your printer and will end up with a result that works. So, I am very excited. I'm very excited. We might also have a guest star. This good boy here has decided to come in and join me today. So if you see a tail or hear a small scream, small cat scream, that's Dipper. This here.
Yeah.
He's hanging out just off camera. So, okay. Wow. Look at all y'all. I am so happy to see you. You guys are fantastic. So, before I get building, because I'm gonna build this, and I'm gonna show y'all how it's done, and I'm gonna kind of explain the process while I do it. Don't worry, you don't need to remember it. It's all gonna be in the instruction guide. But just to give you an idea, I want to know what you guys want to know about it. What are your questions? What are your burning questions? What are you uncertain about? What do you want to know? Of course, as things pop into my head, I will share them as well. But I want to know. It is great framing. It's excellent framing. Yeah, no, there is absolutely a small orange boy to my immediate right. You just can't see him, but he wanted to hang out for moral support. He's a very good boy. Yes. If y'all don't come up with questions, then I'm just gonna come up with stuff, and y'all are just gonna have to deal with it. Layer height and print time. Layer height is an easy one. I have tested it extensively with a 0.2 millimeter layer height, and it works perfect. I have actually not really tested it so much with a 0.3 layer height. However, it absolutely should work. The fit of the pieces should not be terribly influenced by the layer height. So I would love to see somebody give it a try with a 0.3 layer height and to see how it works, preferably with the test pieces, which I will be releasing with the model. But I have only done it at a 0.2. I apologize for the noise. Somebody is being a monkey and climbing up the catch. So yeah, as far as print time is concerned, it obviously will vary on the size of your frame. The A5 frame, very easy, can be printed on a Prusa Mark 3S in pretty much one go. I seem to recall the print time was probably around 9-10 hours, whereas the 14x17 frame, you're gonna be like that? Is that how it's gonna be? You can make all the noise. Yeah, no, I had a feeling that this would happen. Where was I? 14x17 frame took 3 Prusa sized print beds to create. So depending on the size of the frame is going to obviously determine how long it takes. How do you get it? How do you get it? That's a very good question. It is going to be for sale via Gumroad, but also basically through my personal website, because Gumroad is smart and has plugins. It will be available basically by the unit type. So you'll have the 4 different variations, your inches, your A sizes, your B sizes, and your centimeters. And basically, if you combine, they're cheaper. So if you get one, it'll be one price. If you get two, it'll be less, 3, less, so on and so forth. It will be hopefully available very soon, but I don't have an exact date yet. So I do ask for a bit of patience, but I'm working very hard right now to make sure that it gets out as soon as possible. And my hope is next week. So cross your fingers that everything goes according to plan and then it'll be available. Filament is just PLA. It really doesn't require anything fancy. It just honestly requires a bit of stiffness. I would say probably not to do it in TPU because you don't want a flexible picture frame that might not work so well. But PLA really is just ideal for this. And it works like a charm. All of my frames have been in PLA. As you can see, I've had a bit of fun with color. This is just a filament swap. Nothing terribly fancy, something that's very easy to do in Prusa Slicer these days. And you can make some really, really interesting effects with it that way. And I actually need to do more experimenting with it because it's really fun. What do we got here? Gotta get caught up. Galaxy Black would be amazing for this. I suppose I probably shouldn't apologize for Cat because cats are awesome. One of these days, Sean will know how to spell my name correctly. Love you! So what else we got? So I see a question about gluing it. Actually, you don't need to. That's part of the reason why the fit is really important. You don't actually need to glue it. The pieces are such that they fit together very well and tightly. Basically, I do a whole walkthrough in the instructions as to how to make sure you get this fit. But it's good. It's strong. And when you actually have the whole frame together, like so, it holds its shape. There's no need for glue. There is a need for either screws or a bit of glue to attach the backing pieces, but only that. And I actually highly recommend using screws so that you can open it back up again if need be. That's kind of up to you, but the pieces actually, they don't need glue at all. You are welcome to glue if you'd like, but it's not actually my recommendation because if you've printed them correctly and with the right tolerances, you can actually take them back apart again. And so if you say needed to travel or to move house, if you don't glue it, you can still do that. So I don't actually recommend glue. What do we got? But no, actually, yes, super glue totally does work on PLA. I use it all the time. You can absolutely use super glue. I'm not gonna tell you, if you want a super permanent frame, if you want a frame that is never gonna come apart until the end of time, you're welcome to glue the pieces. But like I just displayed, it's not actually necessary. It's maybe even not what you want to do. So, it makes a really fantastic, very satisfying sound. The stream that I did for Verf, my video didn't have any sound. So you guys didn't actually get to appreciate the cool sound it makes. But today you will get to appreciate the cool sound it makes. It's quite satisfying, actually. Snapping the pieces together feels really good. I'm not joking. I legitimately have taken these pieces apart and put them together so many times. And as you can see, they're perfectly fine. Like, there is no damage to them for doing it. They're tough. They're rough and tough. So you can treat them harshly. They'll be okay. It's strong. It's very good. What else we got? What else you guys got for me? I know it's not a question, but it's a thing to share. So I mentioned that these will be for sale on my website through the Glory and Grace of Gumroad. I will actually be selling two options. There will be two options for these. There will be what I'm calling the consumer option, which will be just STLs, and you will get a series of test prints so that you can find the correct tolerance for your printer, the right size fit for your printer, as well as STLs in all of those four sizes. Now, I have deliberately chosen these four sizes because they are good middle grounds. But there is always the chance that you will not have a quite perfect fit. That's okay. These do work if they have a slightly tighter fit and they require a little bit more force. They're still perfectly okay. But as I kind of explained in my instruction guide, you want to err towards a slightly too tight fit over too loose. Too loose can end more badly. So there'll be the consumer side one. But then there's also going to be the professional, the pro, the CAD user side, in which I will actually be selling the CAD files, both a STEP file and a Fusion 360 file. And the Fusion 360 file will actually come with built-in parameters so that you can alter the tolerances of both the space between the length fit, the corner fit, and the space for the backing. That can all be altered in parameters in the Fusion file. So if you have Fusion 360 or any other CAD software and you know what you're doing and you would prefer to have a little bit finer control, as well as the ability to create custom lengths, then the professional version is going to be the one for you. So a little something for everyone. I wanted to make sure there was I was covering all my bases. So yes, Sean, I will be assembling this on stream. In fact, I might start putting it together, because I mean it takes a little bit of time. It doesn't take too long. I just wanna. So the hex and the screws. Let's see. These are M310 screws. I don't know if I'll be able to get this up close enough for y'all to see. It'll be in the instructions. Are for these little back plates, and these slot into the corners, and as you can see, they've got holes in them for said screws. This is what allows you to hang it. As you can see, there is an L-shaped kind of screw mount there so that you can hang it both landscape and portrait orientation. There's also a small hole that you can use a bit of wire if you prefer that as your hanging method. I actually did a bit of a interviewing people how they like to hang their pictures, and I got basically some people liked screws and some people liked wires. So there's two options for both. So you will potentially need some M3x10 screws, or like I said before, you can glue the backing on, but I recommend the screws. I think the screws are a bit better. So did y'all catch a bit of Flying Cat there? He's decided that I'm not entertaining enough, and so he's left. Will you do a multi-frame version for those mini pictures, collage, wall frame things? So that is perhaps the one thing that this frame doesn't do, is it doesn't really interconnect with itself. It doesn't have any way of connecting together. However, they do sit together pretty nicely, quite flush, because they are the same size in whatever this measurement is. So they will actually sit next to each other really nicely, but they don't currently have a method of like slotting together. So it would be potentially up to you to find a way to arrange them so that they're kind of interconnected. Of course, if you get the professional version with the CAD files, then perhaps you can make your own alterations and maybe make some that are interconnected. That would be kind of cool. Just saying. What do we got? Magnets. Actually, yeah, magnets is totally what I was thinking. You could totally just put some little inserts in the frame for magnets, and then you're good to go. But I'm gonna leave that up to you. I've worked on this long enough. I'm not adding anything else. My Fusion file is an actual trash fire, so I'm not adding anything to it, sorry. All right, so I am I am going to start. I'm going to start building this. And y'all are still welcome to ask questions, and I will answer them as they come up. We'll also have a little bit of water because I'm thirsty. How am I doing so far? Not so bad? Acceptable? Satisfactory? So-so? You guys are awesome. I'm so glad you're here. This is something I've been looking forward to for a while now. So this is good times. So to get started, I like to arrange the pieces in more or less their final form. So we've got corner pieces, like so. And this is also me having to remember exactly how this goes, because I printed this a while ago, and I don't fully remember how this lays out. So I think it's like that, and then like that. Yeah, that looks right. That looks right. And then we've got the long ones here. So let's see if I can actually get this so y'all can see it on the second camera. Because I don't know if y'all noticed, I set up an overhead camera for y'all. That's how much I love you. This required effort because the GoPro did not want to work with my computer, but I got there. So just so you know. So, okay, we are getting there, and I'm pretty certain that this looks about right. So let's kind of take that. Yeah, that looks right. I think that is the correct layout for a B4 picture. So now that I've gotten it more or less laid out correctly, you got to kind of pay attention to the directions in which things slot together. I do apologize that this isn't all on camera. Actually, I might be able to do it a little better. No, I don't know. If I adjust the camera, everything might go just right out the window. So, Yes, no, the cat picture is always silently judging. All right, what do y'all think? Should I try and get the camera to be a little bit higher? Yeah, why not? Oh, this is gonna go sideways real quick. Okay, no, I'm not gonna touch it. I don't trust myself. Not screwed up. So yes, we have we have the frame. We have it laid out, and basically there's two types of fits here. We have corner fits and straight fits. Now to get started, I like to kind of start at the bottom. So I'm going to move this up a little bit. Boop, boop, boop. Boop, boop, boop. Start by putting together the corner pieces, and they basically, in fact, I'll kind of get that in front of the GoPro for you. We've got basically just a corner dovetail, and they just kind of slide together like so. A little bit of force to make sure that the fit's good, but as you can see, it's got just the tiniest bit of wobble, but that's normal in the corners. It's hard to have zero wobble, but it's pretty secure. So next. All good. And then sweet, sweet, juicy. Now, admittedly, this is where I can point out that elephant foot can be a problem with these prints. So if you have, fortunately it seems to be just kind of coming off real easily on this one, but if you get a bit of elephant footing on your printer, it's good to try and mitigate that in your settings, in your slicer, because the elephant foot can make sliding the pieces together more difficult. Now, obviously, if you find yourself with a bit of elephant's foot, and you got a handy deburring tool like I do, thanks to Joel Telling, basically you can just kind of run that around real quick, like so. It doesn't matter if it's a little messy, because the fact is you're not going to see it. So, whoop. I feel like I need music in the background. And some, like, 3D printing mood music. I don't know what that would be, but I feel like it would be, honestly, probably a bit hilarious. So, a little bit of deburring. If any of you aren't familiar with this tool, I might just have to link you to the video that I saw Joel do a million years ago that introduced me to it and made me get one. And I am very, very grateful for it. So, a little deburring kind of sorts you out there. Just like so. If you've got a good tolerance on your printer and you've got this well dialed in, it doesn't actually require a whole lot of effort at all. As you can see, it just kind of slides together. Like so. This is the magic at work. See, you know, I've considered having something printing in the background, you know, for background music, for background sound, but I also thought that might not be very professional. So I suppose actually that would be very, very on brand for 3D printing. So, sorry, nothing's printing right now because I have all of one room in which I do everything. As you can see, though, it's got a little wobble, so this could actually maybe be a little tighter, but it's pretty secure. And when it's all together, it will hold its shape well. So I've got the bottom corner done. And from here, add on your sides. Potentially realize you've got a little bit of elephant foot. But that's the thing, if it doesn't fit right away, it's elephant foot's fault. So we just gotta give it a quick sweep with the deburr. We'll be back in business. I had considered doing this in advance, but I thought it would be better to show y'all how to fix this problem, if you have it. Hilariously enough, some of my prints have come off with no elephant foot at all, and others have come off with it, which is really irritating. How do you accommodate for something that changes? So, there we go. That's the good sound. That's the good sound. That's what we like. That's what we like to hear. Is this one good? Is this one going to give me grief? Maybe. Possibly. I want to make sure I'm under the GoPro as much as possible. Yeah, of course. It's going to... As you can see, as soon as I deburr it, it goes on no problem. It's just... wants me to suffer a little bit today. That's okay. Y'all are here to witness my suffering. How's everyone doing? Woo! I see some new faces. I see Brian. I see Hannah. I see Cursey Fabrications. Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for joining me today. My God, you guys are awesome. You guys really know how to make a girl feel like she should maybe be doing streams more often. I wasn't kidding earlier when I said I'd never really considered this. It just wasn't something that was on my radar. But after having so much fun raising money for charity this past weekend, I've started to realize that maybe, actually, streaming's kind of fun. And yeah, I don't know. There we go. Let's try this again. There we go. A little extra push. It doesn't need to sit perfectly flush, but as close as you can get it is pretty nice. So from here, you've got options. Now, I mentioned that you can use a bit of glass or perspex. Sorry, I'm cleaning my scraps off the table. You can use a piece of glass or perspex. I did for this one because since this is original art, it's pastel, I didn't want it to get smudged or anything like that. So I thought that was a good idea. But like for this one, I didn't. It doesn't need it. It's not required, especially if you think you're framing. It has a little bit of stiffness to it. It's not floppy. This is pretty good, which means that you can just take your art and slot it into the front slot, like so. That's pretty simple. But of course, if you did have a piece of glass or perspex you wanted to use, this would be the point where you would put it in. But you want to put in whatever you're putting in the front slot, whether it's... I lost everything for a second there. Everything is, the stream has gone a bit weird on me. I just wanted to make sure we're still live. I think we are. Okay. YouTube glitch. No worries. Just saw my numbers went all wonky. Freaked me out a little. Whatever you're putting into the front slot, you need to do it basically while you have more or less three sides gone on it and not more, because obviously how are you going to slide it in if you've got all four sides built? So once you've got kind of your thing slid in, you can kind of start to put in the rest. Now, this is actually where you need to pay attention to what you're doing, because if you just build up the corners like I did for the first bit, you're going to potentially find yourself in a situation where things aren't going to all go together. So you want to kind of put together the top bit without putting the corners together. Like so. Voila. And kind of line that up a bit. This bit, actually, because I'm not explaining things well, because I'm not scripted. Basically, because of the way the corners work, the straight pieces you can slide in. They slide in this way, but they can also slide back out. The corners slide in one direction. So you want to make sure that you have your receiving corner, basically, this piece. It's basically the one with the slots, as opposed to the one with the extrusion. I don't like saying male and female for these things. I think that's a bit of garbage naming convention, but I'm also lacking better words for it. Because your bit with the extrusion slides into one of the slots, you need to make sure that you've got this basically set up correctly, or you're going to find yourself unable to put it together. So the one with the slots, you want to attach on this side, like so. Then you can put on your top piece, making sure that it's sitting correctly. This is where sometimes it helps to pick it up. I know it's less good for the GoPro, but it's better for me. So I want to make sure that the part is sitting in the slot. And then voila. Now, as you can see, we got one piece left. That's how it should be. You should be finishing up with basically the entire thing together minus one piece. And as you can see, this is also... Oh no, this is bent a bit. Get in there. This is also one of your outie pieces, as opposed to your innie pieces. So this will be your final piece. And you just gotta line it up. Does help to change the angle if you can sometimes. Potentially realize you've got a little bit of elephant that's gonna make elephant foot that's gonna make this difficult. See? And this is why if you don't glue it together, it's okay, because this has got a little bit of elephant foot I need to fix. So I should, in theory, be able to slide this back on. Except for this one's got a little bit of elephant foot on this one as well. So actually, you can take it back apart again. Sometimes it takes a little effort, but there you go. Like so. Like butter. Yeah, I do apologize that my cameras are showing slightly different colors. It's actually a really beautiful teal. It is, for those of you who are wondering, it is Form Futura, I can say that. It's their recycled PLA filament. It's wonderful. It is recycled PLA filament, and it is Turkish blue is the color, which it is admittedly not a blue, it is more of a teal. So I would say that the color you can see in this camera is more accurate to the one you can see in this one. The GoPro is definitely giving it more of a blue tone to it, but it's actually much more of a teal. It's basically my color. It is like the color of my logo, which is part of the reason why I heckin' love it. And I might have to buy 20 of them. So not that I have space, but if I did, I would buy out this color and print everything in it, because it's gorgeous. And it also prints like butter. It prints like a dream. So I cannot actually recommend this filament highly enough. So as you can see, this frame is forgiving. You can get almost done with it, realize that you forgot some elephant foot, take it back apart again, fix the elephant foot, and no harm done. I user experience is something that's really important to me. So in my designs, it's really important that they be usable by as many people as possible. I don't want to design things and make things that only are good if you're a incredibly skilled printer, or if you've got a huge history of design skills, or if you're really technically savvy. Like, those things are great. Don't get me wrong. Kudos to anyone who those things apply to. But I don't want that to be a prerequisite to enjoying something that I've created. Now, the elephant foot is here to ruin my day. It is here to ruin my day. See, sometimes it works better to put it on one direction than another. So we're nearly there. Now we're back to where we were. And yeah, I feel like I need to take a second to breathe. I have not looked at the chat in like 20 minutes, it feels like. What have I missed? I gotta scroll back up a little bit. Brian, your pun is top notch. That's some good dad joke there. I appreciate that, and to the point where I have to point it out. Yay. What else did I miss? Yes, this is my design. Absolutely my design. Totally 100% mine. I'm very pleased with that. Tabs and slots. Innie and outie. Yeah, tabs and slots and innie and outie are both really good. I appreciate that I'm not the only person who potentially uses something other than male and female to describe inanimate objects, because that's weird. Yep, the color is amazing. Gosh, you guys are quick. I think I covered the brand of the filament. In case anyone's wondering, the marble bit is G-Tech. It's just G-Tech PLA marble. It's fine. It's decent. It's not the best I've used, but it's perfectly serviceable. Okay. Thank you, Sean, for finding the link for the filament, because it is a gorgeous filament. So now that I'm caught up, hi everyone. Final piece, we ready. I mean, I'd say drum roll, but I mean, I got no sound. And yeah, so just want to make sure that the art is in place. Voila. If I hadn't, if I actually properly prepared and trimmed the elephant foot to begin with, or better yet, altered my settings so I didn't have elephant foot, this would have taken minutes. Mere minutes. As you can see, it's pretty quick. It is pretty much fully assembled. And yeah, that's good. That's not going anywhere. Now, the back. As you can see, because we put the art in the slot, like the backing is, it's mostly just for the hanging and not so much for holding things in. However, say you used a piece of glass in the front slot, this would be where you put your art. You would basically slide your art into this back slot here, which is actually quite spacious. I'm pretty certain that it is 12 millimeters. However, we'll measure and tell and say for sure, because you can't really trust anyone's memory these days, including my own. So, so the with the backing, you have about 7.5 millimeters of space. Without the backing, it is a full 12. I was correct. So for the people who have asked about LEDs or putting some sort of light source behind it, as you can see, there is space. There is space back here to put stuff if you want. You want to backlight a lithopane or something like that. There is room in the frame for it. Now, if you are putting something kind of completely back here, like something like LEDs, you might want to use, say, a piece of cardboard to kind of cover that and contain the whole thing in, and then use the backing pieces to hold the cardboard in. Just a suggestion. Obviously, there's so many ways you can do this that it's a little bit of that. How many inches? Inches? What's an inch? You can tell I've been here a long time. I don't do things in inches anymore. Let's see. In inches. Oh, what is that? That's... Oh my god. It's like a third of an inch. And... Make me work for this. And actually, that might be a quarter of an inch and a third of an inch space in the back. I can look this up more properly when I have, like, a way to translate measurements. But I'm just, like, the inches measurement on my calipers is not digital. So, though I suppose, actually, oh, no, I can switch it. I just never use it in inches. Ever. So, Mike Kedu, this is for you. You get inches, and it is the space between the backing and the, yes, 0.3135 inches. That's a bonkers number. And the whole backing is just, it's just about actually half an inch. So there you go, inches users. Please don't ask me any more questions about inches. It's painful. I am. Yes, thank you. Yes, ask Alexa. This is Yeah, I'm so glad. Oh my God, I'm so glad you guys are liking it. I'm so glad you guys are liking it. This is definitely like, you don't know how much this means to me. Okay, so to finish up the frame, you really only need two pieces of backing if you don't have the art in the back. If you have the art in the slot like I do, you only need two pieces of backing because that's what you're going to hang it on. If you have the art in the back, like in fact, actually, I can show you an example with Dipper. When you have the art in the back, you can see I used the cardboard to kind of contain it, and then the four pieces of backing to hold it in. When you've got the art in the back, having the four pieces of backing is more important. But if you are Silent Cat judges you over here, if you are just putting it in the slot like I am, if you're not bothering with any glass or acrylic, this is basically all you need. So attaching the pieces. Now, this whole thing, I can't believe nobody has asked this, and if they have, I am sorry I missed it. None of this requires any supports. This is a completely support-free print. In fact, minus a little bit of elephant foot, there's no post-processing either. This is a dead simple print. It just potentially takes a while, depending on how big the frame is. The only thing that you might need to clear out is sometimes with the backing pieces, you'll get a little squiggle of filament, which I just clear out with some flush cutters to make sure it's clear. It's okay if the hole is a little bit messy. Like I oftentimes, like I'll just trim it a little bit to make sure that it's got space for the screws. And I'll also test it kind of in advance. Just to make sure the screw fits before I start trying to screw it in. Because yeah, you know how 3D printers be. Sometimes you get a little bit of plasticky flack. See, what y'all didn't know is that you were getting introduced to weird sounds that Faye makes when she's doing shit. So, didn't say that. I swear, I run a clean shop. No swears here. Only on other people's streams where I'm allowed to. So I'm actually just taking my debris just to clean it up a little bit. But yep, that one's good. Now, this one. Yep, good. Test the other. Now, admittedly, I'm going to tell you all a secret. If you watched my VRF presentation and you saw the video of me assembling the A5 piece, what you didn't see is the fact that the screw holes were slightly too small, and so the amount of effort it actually took to screw those screws in was excruciating. And through the wonder of editing, you couldn't tell. I have since fixed them, and now, as you will see, the screw holes are fine. This is why testing is important, because if you just create something and release it to the world, there's a really good chance that something will kill your hand when you're trying to build it. So this is all good. It all fits. Since this is oriented this way, we want the pieces like so, which actually I just realized it doesn't matter which way it's oriented, except for the fact that only where we're placing them. But yeah, they just kind of just fit in like so. Just want to make sure y'all can see. And then yeah, it's pretty simple. It's just screw it in some screws, which you can totally get started with your hands. Yeah, in this case, four screws. If you had if you were putting out all four, you'd need eight. Simple math. can even screw in 2 screws at the same time, because I'm very, very skilled that way. And then, yeah, just tightening these bad boys up while I attempt to... Can I whisper a bit louder? I'm so sorry. I'm not using a fancy microphone for this, so I hope y'all can hear me okay. I'm realizing I didn't ask very, very much, so I'm just kind of assuming. I'm going off the fact that I'm usually very loud. Very, very loud. Very loud American. Now, sometimes the screws don't seem to stop screwing in for some reason. On some of them they do, and on some of them they don't. I'm not sure if that is a fault in my design, but the fact is they're secure, so it's okay. It's possible that M10s are slightly too short, and you need an M12 or something, but it's fine, basically. As long as it's an M3, it will work. It will go in. It will secure. Boop. And yeah, that is quite literally it. Now you can hang it. As you can see, it actually stands up perfectly fine on its own. So this can be a table frame if you'd like. As I mentioned before, the backing pieces can accommodate 2 different types of hanging. This will take a 8-gauge wall screw, or if you're metric, 4.5-millimeter wall screw, which is just the basic, you know, you screw the screw into the wall and slide it on top. But as I mentioned as well, it'll take 1-millimeter wire as well if you want to basically do the put a piece of wire and then like balance that on a nail. I realize I'm saying it like I have no idea what I'm talking about because I don't use that method, but apparently it's a method of hanging picture frames. So, you know, no judgment. But that's it. It's done. That is how it's done. This is basically what I feel like I've needed my whole life. I don't know about y'all, but I always have a million things to frame and hang because I'm an artist and I like art and I like having art on the walls. So I feel as though I've got everything I need now to frame stuff forever. And basically, if you purchase the files, you will too, because obviously you pay once, you have unlimited frames in basically any size you can come up with within that unit of measurement. That's kind of the glory of it. So hopefully if you're somebody like me who has way too much stuff to frame, this will help. This will make your life a lot easier and give you the ability to choose your colors and to mix and match and to really get creative with your framing without paying hundreds of dollars to a custom framer because yeah. Ain't nobody got time for that. What do we got? Is it food safe? You shouldn't be eating your picture frame, nor should you be eating off of it. Just a suggestion. No, PLA isn't food safe. It never has been, and it never will be, and you shouldn't eat off of PLA. It's just generally not a good idea. But yeah, I see I missed a question. Are the screws countersunk or do they sit proud? That's a great question. Thank you. They are countersunk. Hopefully, if the lighting is all right, you can kind of see that they sit flush. They are totally countersunk, and so they will not interfere with your wall hanging. It should be fine. All right, I'm feeling pretty good about this. How are y'all feeling? I want to make sure that I have covered any questions about this, because the thing is that I'm aware that it's a slightly weird thing, and there's a lot of potential things going on here, and as much as I have every intention of covering everything in the instructional guide, I want to be able to kind of be upfront. I realize that spending money on STLs is not something that everyone feels super comfy about. And so I want to make sure that everyone who's looking at this feels like, well, like they're getting their money's worth, that they are, that they're paying for something quality and something that has put a lot of time and effort and thought into. So I am here to basically reassure y'all that's what's happening here, that this is something that has been thoroughly tested and will work as described. So yeah, is it cat safe? It is as cat safe as anything I own, which is to say, sort of. It is actually, again, it's surprisingly robust. Like, this isn't going to accidentally come apart, for sure. As you saw, it can be pulled apart, it can be disassembled, which I think is kind of crazy and cool, but it's not coming apart. So, like, if this got knocked over, it's got as much of a chance of breaking as probably any other PLA print, I suppose. Like, there's always a chance it fell from a great height, but, and there's always a chance with a cat that it could be falling from a great height, but it is, it's tough. I wanted it to be tough. This is a household item. It shouldn't be delicate. You're putting it up on the wall. You shouldn't have to worry about it too much. I'm not throwing it in here. I have a whole shelf of prints up there. Bad things would happen. that's more me not trusting me than the print. I am really, really glad that you all have enjoyed this. And to say thank you, as I may have hinted, I'm basically giving you all the chance to get a bit of a discount because you guys have come to support me today, and I really appreciate that. And even if you've watched this stream after the fact, you still have a chance. So if you use the code Livestream, we'll make this simple. When the item goes on sale, you will get 15% off. And that's if you buy one, that's if you buy all four, it's 15% off everything. Now, this will be limited to the first 20 people who purchase the files. So you are going to need to pay attention to when I release it, because as much as you have this information now, you're going to have to hold on to it until the files are released. So write it down, make a note, do what you need to do. Yeah, I guess this is my own Black Friday. Nah, this is I can't come up with a good name for this on the fly. It is what it is. It's a thank you for supporting my work as an artist and a maker, and for checking me out and hanging out with me today on my live stream. That's what it is. So yeah, live stream, write it down. When it goes on sale, first 20 people, 15% off. Bob's your uncle. I still have not finalized the price, but I can say that it's going to be around $5 for the STL only version for one, and probably somewhere between 7 and 10 for the CAD files. Like I mentioned before, if you combine, they will be cheaper. They won't be 5555, for example. But I haven't finalized the price yet, so it might go up, it might go down, but not by much. I'm feeling pretty good about it. So Teal Friday, I like that so much better. Thank you, Anna. It's much better. I will announce on Twitter. I will announce on Instagram. That's basically kind of where I do things, and I'll make sure to retweet it a few times and make sure that everyone sees it. But I guess also if you want to be extra safe, yeah, bookmark my site. Sean just posted it, and keep an eye on it. It's obviously still really plain right now because I've been using a placeholder for a while. But it's gonna get a bit of an update and an overhaul when the piece goes up. So just keep your eyes peeled. Ah, You guys are great. I can't believe I talked for a whole gosh darn hour. I genuinely wasn't certain how long this was gonna go on for. So, and yes. They will be on time for Christmas if I have to like go out and threaten some people, and I guess I'm one of those people since I need to finish some stuff myself. I will be doing my absolute darndest to have this up before December. So definitely before Christmas, but hopefully before like December even. So yeah, because you know it's good whether you celebrate Christmas or Hanukkah or any other non-denominational winter holiday that involves gift giving, because who doesn't like giving gifts? Yeah, it'll be up by then. Pinky swear. Oh, thank you. I was gonna say I like my Kill la Kill models as well. I can't claim sculpting those. Those aren't my work, but the painting is. The painting is all mine, and I actually still need to finish Tatsuki. Yeah, that's the thing that needs to be done. So, any final questions before I let y'all get on with your day? I have had an absolute blast. If y'all liked this kind of format, this kind of setup, please let me know, because I am very much still finding my sea legs with this whole YouTube thing. And as much as I have every intention to continue doing regular videos because they're so much fun and I'm loving it, if y'all like this kind of thing, then I definitely think it could happen more often. As it is, I am already considering doing a live stream wig styling, because I have a cosplay wig I need to completely tear apart and rebuild. And I thought that might be an interesting thing. I have a rep box I need to build. I've got some stuff that could be good live streaming material. And so if y'all like it, then let me know. And that means that it's more likely that there'll be more of them. If you guys didn't like it, then you can tell me that too, and I'll focus more on making videos. So basically, I like honesty. I like knowing what y'all think. You were encouraged to share, and to share your honest opinion, I can handle it. So what's for dinner? I don't actually know. It is approaching dinner time, isn't it? But no, I don't actually know what I'm having for dinner. Yeah. I am so glad. Thank you, you guys. You guys are fantastic. I cannot promise cooperative cats. They are the owner and I am the pet in this relationship. So I can't promise more cooperative cats, but I mean, like, you never know. There might be a cat in the stream. It's anyone's guess. Yeah, exactly. What is a cooperative cat? Do I have photos of my cosplay work posted somewhere? So I do not have, I had to basically kind of overhaul some online stuff, which means that I don't actually have any currently. However, I'm hoping to change that real soon. So if you like cosplay stuff, definitely stay tuned, because there is cosplay stuff in the works, and there will be more coming and stuff to look at hopefully real soon, because I've got a costume that's literally on the cusp. So there will be more cosplay stuff to see very soon. I see I clashed with some other people's streams. So yeah, no, I'm definitely still trying to figure out kind of what times are good for this sort of thing, as well as what times are good for me. And today, this time was good for me. So I realized that I was clashing with some other stuff, but hopefully in the future there will be less clashing and some tweaking to try to figure out what's good. I think we're good. I think we're good. I guess I will wrap up here. I don't know how you end a stream, because I've never done it before, but all I can think to say is thank you so, so much for everyone who is here. I can see your names in the chat if you're chatting, and I love you. You've made my day. You've made this little nerd very happy. And yeah, keep keep your eyes peeled. This will be getting announced very, very soon. And you gotta retweet it. You gotta shout about it so that everyone knows about it. And then I can keep making cool stuff. I think that's how that works. So in the meantime, thank you so much, everyone. I hope you have a wonderful day, those of you who are in the American time zones. Those of us here in Europe, I hope you have a good evening. And if you're in Australia, God, you are committed, and I really appreciate you staying up so dang late. Until next time, I suppose. Thanks again, everyone. Bye.